Good morning, Life Point Church, and happy birthday, Mr. Harry Houdini. Do you know who that is? Well, on this day in 1874, Mr. Houdini, whose real name was Eric Weiss, was born. This man built his career on the notion that he could escape from anything. I want to read these to you so that I don't mess them up. He escaped from handcuffed. All of these were handcuffed. He escaped from an enormous paper bag without tearing the bag. Sunken packing crates, padded cells, coffins, a roll-top desk, burglar-proof safes, a preserved giant squid, a giant football, a diving suit, a U.S. mail pouch, and a plate glass box. While acts like Houdini's amaze us and leave us thinking, how in the world did he do that? These feats of trickery pale in comparison to the great escapes of the Bible. Do you remember a story about Paul and Silas? While in Philippi, they were beaten, arrested, and thrown into the dungeon of the prison. They weren't just in the prison. They were in the deepest, deepest part of the prison. And since the jailer was ordered not to let Paul and Silas escape, he further clamped their feet into leg stocks, a type of feet cuffs. Get the picture? Yet in the middle of the night, as Paul and Silas were singing hymns of praises to God, an earthquake shook the prison. The prison doors flew open. The chains of every prisoner fell off. But Paul and Silas did not just go running straight out. They remained in the jail. And because they stayed, the jailer wanted to know all about the God that they worshipped. That very night, the jailer and his entire family were saved. Paul and Silas didn't have to rely on sleight of hand or illusions. Instead, they relied on God. When we get into a situation, we can sometimes think that we've got to do it on our own. We've got to do it maybe through some trickery. Maybe we feel like Jacob did, where I'm not going to make it in life unless I trick people and kind of go the wrong way about it. But just as Jacob learned and just as Paul and Silas showed us so beautifully, the best way to get through any situation is by relying on God. In Job 9:10, it says, "He does great and unsearchable things, wonders without number. He is truly a miracle worker. If you get to know him, you can put your trust in him. And when you put your trust in him, he does mighty, marvelous works for his people. I hope you get to experience one of them today, and I hope you have a blessed day and feel his presence surrounding you. God bless you."